Wilms' tumor is a type of kidney cancer in children. It most often affects children under the age of 5. More children than ever are surviving childhood cancer. There are new and better drugs and treatments, and we can now also work to reduce the after effects of having had cancer in the past. It is devastating to hear that your child has cancer, and at times it can feel overwhelming. There are many healthcare professionals and support organizations to help you through this difficult time. Understanding more about the cancer your child has and the treatments that may be used can often help parents to cope. Your child's specialist will give you more detailed information. If you have any questions, it's important to ask the specialist doctor or nurse who knows your child's individual situation. Wilms' tumor is a type of kidney cancer that was named after Dr. Max Wilms, who first described it. It's thought to come from very specialized cells in the embryo known as metanephric blastema. These cells are involved in the development of the child's kidneys while they are in the womb. The cells usually disappear at birth, but in many children with Wilms' tumor, clusters of primitive kidney cells, called nephrogenic rests, can still be found. The kidneys are a pair of organs found at the back of the abdomen. They clean the blood by removing excess fluids and waste products, which are then converted into urine. Causes in most children, the causes of Wilms' tumor are unknown. Very rarely, people who develop Wilms' tumor have other specific conditions which are present at birth, congenital malformations. These include the lack of an iris in the aneuridia, abnormalities of the genitals, and a condition where one side of the body is slightly larger than the other, hemihypertrophy. In 1 in 100 people with Wilms' tumor, another family member will also have Wilms' tumor. Signs and symptoms: the most common symptom is a swollen abdomen, which is usually painless. Sometimes a parent or carer may feel a lump in the abdomen which can be quite large. Occasionally, the tumor may bleed slightly, and this can irritate the kidney and may be painful. There may be blood in your child's urine, pee, or their blood pressure may be raised. The child may also have a high temperature, fever, upset stomach, weight loss, or a lack of appetite. How Wilms' tumor is diagnosed: a variety of tests and investigations may be needed to diagnose a Wilms' tumor. An abdominal ultrasound scan is usually the first thing that is done. This will be followed by an MRI and/or CT scan of the abdomen and chest. These scans help doctors to identify exactly where the tumor is and whether it has spread beyond the kidney. This is known as staging. Urine and blood samples will also be taken to check your child's kidney function and general health. Most children will go on to have a biopsy, where a sample of tissue is taken from the tumor to confirm the diagnosis. Any tests and investigations that your child needs will be explained to you. Staging: the stage of a cancer is a term used to describe its size and whether it has spread beyond its original site. Knowing the particular type and the stage of the cancer helps doctors decide on the most appropriate treatment. In the case of a Wilms' tumor, the stage is finalized after surgery to remove the tumor. As most Wilms' tumor patients receive chemotherapy before surgery, you may not know the exact stage of your child's tumor straight away. An exception is that babies under 6 months old usually have surgery straight away. Stage 1: the tumor is only affecting the kidney and has not begun to spread. It can be completely removed with surgery. Stage 2: the tumor has begun to spread beyond the kidney to nearby structures, but it's still possible to remove it completely with surgery. Stage 3: the tumor has spread beyond the kidney either because the tumor has burst before or during the operation, has spread to lymph glands nodes, or has not been completely removed by surgery. Stage 4: the tumor has spread to other parts of the body such as the lungs or liver. Tumors in other parts of the body are known as metastases. Stage 5: there are tumors in both kidneys, bilateral Wilms' tumor. If the tumor comes back after initial treatment, this is known as recurrent cancer or relapse. Treatment is planned by specialists in children's tumors and cancers. This is usually based in a children's oncology unit within a main hospital, but some treatment may be given closer to home. Treatment will depend on a number of factors, including how the cells appear under the microscope, histology, and the stage of the tumor. Treatment may include chemotherapy, radiotherapy, or surgery. Surgery: all children with Wilms' tumor will have surgery. Initially, this may only involve taking a small sample of cells from the tumor to confirm the diagnosis. This is called a biopsy and is usually done under a general anesthetic using a needle inserted through the skin. Apart from very young children under 6 months, most patients will receive chemotherapy before having a bigger operation to remove the entire tumor. The operation usually involves removing the whole of the affected kidney, nephrectomy. After examining the whole tumor under the microscope, Wilms' tumors can be divided into a number of risk groups based on knowledge about how these different types of tumors are likely to behave. The treatment following surgery will depend on these risk groups. The risk groups are known as low, standard or intermediate, and high. The majority of tumors are in the standard risk group. So-called low-risk tumors require less treatment than standard risk tumors. Two types of Wilms' tumor, anaplastic and blastemal, are considered to be higher risk than other Wilms' tumors and require more intensive, stronger chemotherapy. Anaplastic Wilms' tumor, about 5% to 10% of Wilms' tumors have an appearance called anaplasia, which means the cells look very disorganized under a microscope. Blastemal Wilms' tumor, this group of high-risk tumors cannot be identified by looking at the biopsy because they occur when a particular type of early kidney cell survives the pre-surgery chemotherapy. These cells are known as blastemal cells. Tumors, where most of these cells survive chemotherapy, are called blastemal tumors. Other kidney tumors, less common types of kidney tumors may occur in children. These are usually only recognized after surgery to obtain a tumor sample. Clear cell sarcoma and malignant rhabdoid tumor of the kidney are two types of cancerous tumor, with their own treatment recommendations. Congenital mesoblastic nephroma is a non-cancerous benign tumor that occurs in very young children. This type of tumor usually only needs surgery and no other treatment. Chemotherapy is the use of anti-cancer cytotoxic drugs to destroy cancer cells. It's usually given as an injection or drip into a vein intravenously. Chemotherapy given before surgery is called neoadjuvant chemotherapy. What doctors find out about the tumor after surgery, for example, how the cells look under the microscope and how far the cancer has spread, helps them to decide whether additional chemotherapy should be given adjuvant chemotherapy. This is to help reduce the risk of the cancer coming back recurring. This chemotherapy may be given as inpatient or outpatient depending on tumor staging and risk group. Radiotherapy treats cancer by using high energy rays to destroy the cancer cells, while doing as little harm as possible to normal cells. Not all children with Wilms' tumor need radiotherapy. For those that do, the area to be treated depends on the stage of the tumor at diagnosis. Some children receive radiotherapy to the area around the affected kidney or, less commonly, to the whole abdomen. If the tumor has spread to the lungs, then lung radiotherapy may be needed, but this depends on how well the cancer responds to initial chemotherapy. It's not always needed. Radiotherapy may occasionally be used to shrink tumors that are too large to remove surgically. This will, ideally, allow an operation to be done. Radiotherapy can also be used when tumors have spread elsewhere in the body. Treatment for bilateral Wilms' tumor: in about 1 in 20 cases, Wilms' tumor affects both kidneys. Treatment usually involves surgery to both. The aim of the treatment is to remove as much of the cancer as possible, while leaving as much healthy kidney as possible. Chemotherapy is always given. Sometimes radiotherapy is needed as well. Side effects of treatment: treatment for Wilms' tumor often causes side effects. Your child's doctor will discuss this with you before treatment starts. Many side effects are expected and managed effectively. Side effects can include feeling sick, nausea and being sick, vomiting, hair loss, bruising and bleeding, tiredness, diarrhea, and an increased risk of infection. Less common effects may include impact on the heart, kidneys, and liver. Late side effects: a small number of children may develop late side effects, sometimes many years later. These include a possible reduction in bone growth, a change in the way the heart and lungs work, and a slight increase in their risk of developing another cancer in later life. Infertility is a possible late side effect, although this is rare. Your child's doctor or nurse will talk to you about any possible late side effects. These will depend on the exact treatments given. Clinical trials: many children have their treatment as part of a clinical research trial. Trials aim to improve our understanding of the best way to treat an illness. The trial may include comparing the standard treatment with a new or modified version. It may just involve collecting patient and tumor details, including response to treatment, to increase specialist knowledge. If appropriate, your child's medical team will talk to you about taking part in a clinical trial, and will answer any questions you have. Written information will be provided to help explain things. Taking part in a research trial is completely voluntary, and you will be given plenty of time to decide if it's right for your child. Treatment guidelines: sometimes, clinical trials are not available for your child's tumor. This may be because a recent trial has just finished, or because the tumor is very rare. In these cases, you can expect your doctors and nurses to offer treatment which is agreed to be the most appropriate, using guidelines which have been prepared by experts across the country. The Children's Cancer and Leukemia Group (CCLG) is an important organization which helps to produce these guidelines. Follow-up care: most children with Wilms' tumor are cured. If the cancer comes back, it's usually within the first 2 years. When one kidney is removed, the other will be able to work normally and can take over the work of the other kidney. Very few children have long-term kidney problems. Your child will have regular checkups to look for any recurrence or problems following treatment. If you have specific concerns about your child's condition and treatment, it's best to discuss them with your child's doctor, who knows the situation in detail.